Removal van arrives at Lily Allen's luxury flat after her Italian tenant said she was astonished at hypocrite. Stars claim she and her three children are refusing to leave the £2 million property. A removal van has been spotted at Lily Allen's luxury London home after her Italian tenant branded her a hypocrite for claiming she and her three children were refusing to leave. The vehicle was spotted outside the star's Notting Hill home this afternoon amid an ongoing spat between her and the woman living there. Miss Allen, who cried on camera in the Calais jungle saying she 100% put up a refugee, took to Twitter yesterday to complain how she was unable to move back into her £2 million home because her Italian tenants were claiming diplomatic immunity. But Italian tenant Maria Bellotta, 38, a photographer, said she had agreed to move out tomorrow and just asked to stay on for 2 extra days. The mother of three told Mail Online, "I'm very sorry I had her as a landlord because all this has happened. We are still living here today but we are leaving." After claiming she was going to be homeless for Christmas, removal men were pictured this afternoon outside the Notting Hill property. In the now-deleted message that started the furor, socialist Miss Allen wrote, "Meant to be moving back into my flat this week, but my tenants just dropped that they can't find anywhere to go up to their standards. Then they said they're diplomats and have diplomatic immunity and there's nothing I can do about it. So, who fancies a family of three for Christmas?" Responding to that today, tenant Mrs. Bellotta said, "I'm really astonished. I don't know why she did this. We are diplomats. But I don't want to make trouble to our embassy. This is so stupid. I can't believe this." Asked if she had anything more to add, she said, "No, because I would never sink so low." Her husband Luca Bellotta, who arrived home on a scooter with Italian diplomatic plates, said, "We were moving out anyway. This is exposing ordinary people to the magnitude of 6 million people. Things are not supposed to work like that. I am not a public figure. It's not on." Mr. Bellotta, who did not want to reveal his job, spent yesterday coordinating removal men who ferried large cardboard boxes in and out of the property. "I just want to be left to be boring," he added. Miss Allen, 32, bought the two-bedroom flat near Queen's Park Station for £900,000 in 2008. It has an estimated rental value of up to £2,250 per month. The year before her purchase, she appeared on the BBC political show This Week, where she talked about money being a massive issue and claimed she could not afford to buy a home in London. "I've been doing what I do for a few years now, and I've been paid pretty well. But even I'm not in a position to buy a one-bedroom flat in the city I grew up in," she said. The millionaire singer later hit back on social media to those who accused her of hypocrisy, insisting she had no shame. Miss Allen, 32, bought the ground floor two-bedroom flat for £900,000 in 2008, and similar properties in the area are worth around £2 million. Her plea comes after the mother of two, the daughter of actor Keith Allen and sister to Game of Thrones star Alfie Allen, sold her £4.2 million Cotswolds mansion last year after she was hit by a hefty tax bill. Her tweet resulted in a flurry of angry responses from her followers, with one branding her a champagne socialist and others starting a Pray for Lily hashtag. One wrote, "Just sing outside their front door, that'll get them shifted in under an hour." Twitter user Paul Watson commented, "Why do you have paying tenants in your flat, Lily, when you could be housing Syrian refugees?" Eleanor Black wrote, "Welcome to the real world. One major difference, you've plenty money, go buy another house." And in a sarcastic reference to the Live Aid fundraising concert, one commenter said, "Bit of a crazy request, but has anyone got Bob Geldof's number? I think we need to organize a concert to buy Lily Allen a £4 million property this Christmas. She's homeless and in need." Last year the 32-year-old came under fire when she apologized to Calais migrants on Britain's behalf before insisting she would 100% take in a refugee herself. She became emotional while meeting with a 13-year-old boy from Afghanistan who had risked his life trying to board UK-bound lorries. The teenager, who said his father lives in Birmingham, has been camped at the jungle on the edge of the northern French port city for 2 months. The clip was aired on the BBC's Victoria Derbyshire show and prompted some viewers to claim her crocodile tears and apology were ridiculous. Asked by the presenter if she would take in an unaccompanied child, she replied, 100%. Who wouldn't? She added, these children are being displaced. If there's room for people in my house, I'm going to take them in. I think anyone would. Critics also accused the star of trying to boost her flagging career, and a former British E commander who served in Afghanistan said, she clearly does not have any understanding of the situation. Miss Allen later hit back by insisting she was only saying sorry to a helpless child for the part this country has played in contributing to his dire situation. The singer, who will be spending Christmas with her daughters Marnie and Ethel, was educated at fee-paying schools including Hill House, which counts Prince Charles among its alumni, and Millfield. She married builder Sam Cooper, the father of her children, in 2011 but they went their separate ways in 2015. She has since been linked to grime DJ Daniel London, with the couple being pictured around London and on holiday in Ibiza together. Under the Diplomatic Privileges Act 1964, diplomats are entitled to immunity from the civil and administrative jurisdiction of the British courts, except in certain circumstances. David Fleming of property legal specialists William Heath & Co. has previously explained how he would always advise a client to be very wary of letting a property to a diplomat. A spokesman for the Italian embassy said, it is not something we want to comment on.